Hello, good morning students. Today we are going to start our new chapter, probability. It is one of easiest chapters in our ninth class, probability. The introduction of probability also we will discuss in seventh class. Again I am repeating, what is the probability? What is meaning of probability? Probabilities mean how, what is the chances of any event. What is the chance? Like this one. Suppose if I ask you if someone is your friend, okay, and you know he is good in study. So what you will do? So you will say that I doubt she will be pass. Understand or not? Suppose. Now in the Mukla, there is rain is coming. Okay, rain is coming. But if yesterday someone asked you what is the possibilities, what is the chances, probability, possibilities, all are same things. What is the probabilities of the rain will come tomorrow? Yes. So always, so we will see the factors of the. And in what cases the rains will come? If there is a dark cloud and thundering and lightning is there, so we will say, sir, I think maybe rain will come. Maybe. We are not sure. Rain will come definitely. We are only probably rain maybe will come. So in maybe next days rain may be come or may not be. Understand or not? Some of that was, tomorrow is a football match between Argentina and Brazil, and you are a big fan of the Brazil team. Then you will say that if I ask you what is the chances of the winning of the Brazil team, so you will say, sir, there is a 50-50 chance to win the match of the Brazil team, because Brazil and Argentina both teams are good team. So we cannot say which one is win. So they are the 50-50 chances of both of the. So these all the words. What is the chances? Chances, doubt, probably, and chances, may. These are all the words indicate the probability. Because in this word, there is a one term is hide. What is uncertainty? We are not certain. Maybe he win or not. Maybe rain will come or not. Understand or not? Suppose like this one. Now is so now this one we already. So this is the probability. So now, so in seventh class we learn one formula to find the probability. If I ask you, suppose I have one coin, okay? It is 1 rupees coin and I throw it. So I toss the coin and what is the probability of head? So you will say that, you know, in every coin, there is a one side head, one side tail. If I ask you, what is the probability of head? Can you tell me? When you toss the coin, what will become? We are not sure. That's why we use coins when we are playing the match and other cases, okay? So this one, because we are not sure what will be come. So it is maybe chances. Half chances of head come, half chances of tails come. Understand? So it means the probability. Here we will discuss empirical probability. Which one? Empirical. Empirical probability. What is empirical probabilities? Yes, in this chapter only one formula. If you understand this formula, you can solve all questions. And I know everyone know how to solve it. This one, so empirical probability. So first only write the formula. What is? If you want to find the probability of any. P mean probability, E mean event. I will tell what is event. So always, how will you find? Total number टोटल नंबर ऑफ ट्रायल्स आई विल टेल यू व्हाट इज ट्रायल्स. फर्स्ट राइट फॉर्मूला, टोटल नंबर ऑफ ट्रायल्स एंड राइट नंबर ऑफ ट्रायल्स इन विच इवेंट हैपन्ड. तो इट इज द फॉर्मूला नंबर ऑफ ट्रायल्स इन विच द इवेंट हैपन्ड. तो इट इज द नोट डाउन इट फॉर्मूला. नाउ वी विल डिस्कस व्हाट इज द प्रोबेबिलिटी. सपोज इंपीरिकल प्रोबेबिलिटी मीन एक्सपेरिमेंटल प्रोबेबिलिटी, ए प्रोबेबिलिटी विच इज बेस्ड ऑन एक्सपेरिमेंट. व्हाट इज एक्सपेरिमेंट? सपोज वी आर डूइंग इन वन एक्सपेरिमेंट. I want to throw this coin is 5 times. Suppose I throw the coins and I note it. It suppose it is 10 come. So I note it, what is come? So first time when we throw the head, throw the coins, what is come? Tail. Again I throw it, the coins. Next time is again tail come. Suppose I write tail second time. Third time, again I toss it. Now this time is head come. Next time, again, it is tail come and last time is also head. So I throw a coin is 5 times and every time's result I note down it. Okay, I note the result. What is the outcomes? What outcomes mean? What is the result? When I throw a coin, that some result will come. Maybe head, maybe tail. So it is the outcome. So it means there is the 3 times is tail and 2 times is head. So it means when we do the an experiment, when we do any experiment, it is called the empirical probability. Empirical means a probability which is based on experiment. Because here we based on experiment, because we do ourselves, we throw the coins 5 times and what is the head end? And if I ask you, what is the probability of head? When we throw a coin 5 times and its outcomes we note down. So what is the probability of head come? So total number of trials. Trials mean how many times we throw the coins. If we throw a coin, toss the coins 1 time, so it is 1 trial. If I toss the coin 2 times, it is 2 trials. So how many times we throw, we toss the coin? 5 times. So it means number of trials how much? 5. Understand it? Next is number of trials. Which one number of trials? In which event happened? Event. E. So it means same as it is. Number of trials in which event? E event. E mean event. It mean had happened. Number of trials in which, whose probability you want to find? Had happened. Had is how many times? 2 times. So what is the probability of head? 2/5. So it is the empirical probability. Empirical probability means which is based on experiment. When we throw, and number trials mean if we throw a coin 1 time, so it is 1 trial. If we throw 2 times, so 2 trials. Same as it is. Probability of tell when we throw the coins 5 times. The total number of trials 5 and tells how many times? 1, 2, 3. So 3/5. The number of trials in which tail happened. Tail. T happened. Okay. It mean E mean whose probability we want to find. Event happened. He whose probability had. So had how many times? 2 times. Whose probability? Tell. Tell is 3/5. So it is the empirical probability. Note down its formula. So remember this one. Understand it? And now we will do our exercise. Note down it. Do you remember in 7th class we discussed only we did not discuss in 7th class empirical probability. We discussed only classical probability. What is the probability of head when we throw a coin 1 time? Either head come or tail come. So what is the probability of head? 1/2. Understand or no? So it is, here we are not throwing the coins. He is only asking when we throw the coins, what is the probability of head? 1 upon 1 is 1 time and total is 20. Okay. But here we will discuss empirical. Empirical means which is based on experiment. So now question number 1 of 15.1. Okay, it is very easy exercise. Only you should remember the formulas. Okay, so note down it. In a cricket match, a batsman hits a boundary 6 times out of 30 balls played. A batsman played 30 balls and she hits a boundary how many times? 6 times. Understand? Then find the probability that she did not hit a boundary. So we have to find the probability when she did not hit the boundary. Understand or not? Right? You can write number of balls played by batswoman. How much? Number of balls is 30 balls and she hit the ball how many times? 6 times. Tell me, if you are playing sports cricket and if I throw you 2 balls, or I throw you 6 balls, you hit the boundary of 2 balls, it means you did not hit the boundary. How many balls? 4 balls. It means 4 balls you did not hit it. That means batsman did not hit the boundary a ball. How many times? So total ball was she played 30 and she hit the boundary 6. So 30 minus 6. How many times? So 24 times she did not hit the boundary. And whose probability we have to find? She did not hit the boundary. So always first write formula. What is probability? Whose? Did not hit boundary. Because in formula what I wrote? P into E. E mean event. Whose probability we want to find? Whose probability we want to find? Did not hit the boundary. How will you find? Total number of trials. How many trials is here? 30 trials, because she played how many balls? 30. So total number of trials. And next, number of. Yes. Whose probability we want to find? Did not hit the. So number of the balls. Did not hit boundary. Understand? She did not hit the boundary. So now, what is total number of trials? Total number of balls she played 30 and did not hit 24 divided by. And now we always cut. We will write in the simplest form. 6, 4, 6, 5. So what is the probability she did not hit the ball? 4 upon 5.
So it is a question.
Only you have to remember this formula. Probability, total number of trials is divided by number of trials in which event is happened. Understand it? Note down it. And now we will do second question. Yes, 1500 families with 2 children were selected randomly. What is meaning of randomly? Randomly word we already learned in 7th class. Randomly means an event in which a result which we cannot predict in advance. Advance means, suppose I want to throw a coin, I toss a coin. Can you tell me what result we will come in advance? No, we cannot tell what result will be come. So it means
Here it is the randomly. Randomly mean in which we cannot predict the result in advance. Okay, we cannot tell what we will become. Okay, so it means so a survey was conducted on 1500 families with two children were selected randomly, and the following data was recorded. So what is data? Data is number of girls in a family and number of families. What is given? Number of girls in a family.
Which means
a survey was conducted on 1500 families and with two children were selected. So we selected two children, okay, randomly. What is and the following data? It means and one girls in
A184
and zero girls on.
So it means
out of 1500 family there are 470 families, total families. You can count 5 plus 4 9 9 plus 1 10. So this one total is count 1500. Okay, so total families in 1500, out of 1500 there is 475 families whose both children are, because survey was conducted on two children. It means both of the two children, maybe boys, maybe girls. But how many families out of 1500 families, 470 families has two girls. Both are, out of two children, both are girls. And 814 families have only one girls. If it is one girls, it means one is boys, one is girl, one is boy. And 211 families which have what is zero girls. It means if it's zero girls, it means two children what are? Both are two boys. Understand? Either you will say it is zero girls, either you can say that two boys. How many, if I ask you, how many families which have two boys? So how many? 211. How many family in which have only zero girls? So 211. How many girls? How many families in which have only zero boys? So 475. Because out of two children, both are two are girls. It means boys are zero. So first is compute the probability of family when chosen at random having two girls. So we have to find probability of whose two girls. So how will you find? So earliest family, total number of trials, and this survey is conducted by on how many families? 1500. Total number of trials how much? Right, total number of families, yeah, total number of trials you can write any. Okay, total number of families, and you write number of families whose probability two girls, number of families have two girls. So how many families there? Two girls. 475 divided by 1500. Understand? So it is the probability of the two girls. Understand? Always we will write the formulas, and we will write in simplest form. 5 9 5 5 5 3 0. Understand it? Now 5 19 5 60. So what is the probability? 19 divided by 60. Understand it? Same as it is. Next is probability of whose
of one girl. One girl.
Always first one time we will write formula, then we will solve that. Okay? So one girl, how many?
One girl, how many family has one girl? 814 divided by 150. So cut 2, 2, 4, 0, 7. 2, 7. So what is probability? 4, 0, 7 by 7.
Understand it? Same as it is. Probability of zero girls.
Zero girls mean 211 divided by 150.
Understand? Understand or not? If I ask you what is the probabilities of two boys? Yes. So which one is two boys? Yes. It means the survey was conducted on two children. And out of two children, there is zero girls. No one is girl. It means both are boys. The boy is how much?
2100. What is? 150.
So examiner maybe ask you any question. Maybe she asks, find the probabilities of number of families of zero boys. So zero boys of how many family? 475 divided by. Understand it? So it, probability of two boys is this. Understand? So note down it. Always we will write one time formula and then we'll solve.
So question number 1, question number 2 and question number 3. Question number 3, one question number 1, question number 2, question number 3 and question number 4 you will do yourself. Question number 3, look at what is question number 3. Question number 3, refer to example 5, section 14.4, the chapter 14. So example number 5 of chapter 14, example number 5, page number, it is on page number, question number 3, it is on page number 247 and question number example 5. What is given?
It is a data is given in example 5. It is data is given in a particular section of the class, of the 9th class. It is data were asked about the month of their birth and the following graph was prepared for the data. So okay, now we will go in the question. Question number 15.1. Find the probability that a student of class has was born in August. So we have to find the probability was born in August. So find the probability a student which was born in August. So how will you find?
First we will find total number of student. And next, number of student. Number of students was born on August.
So it means how many total students in a particular section? How many?
Total students are 40.
And you can see, check it in graph. In August, how many? There are the 6
students. So 6 by, so this one, 2, 3, 2. So what is the probability? 3 divided by 20.
So it is very easy exercise, okay? So do yourself question number 1, 2, 3 and 4. Understand? Question number 1, 2, 3 and 4. And tomorrow we will start our next question of probability. Understand? So thank you everyone. Have a nice day.